I, Jesus, have sent my angel to give you this message for the churches. I am both the source of David and the heir to his throne. I am the bright morning star. The Spirit and the bride say, come. Let anyone who hears this say, come. Let anyone who is thirsty, come. Let anyone who desires, drink freely from the water of life. In Revelation 22:20-21, pick your attention to 21. It is the last word in the Bible. He who is the faithful witness to all these things says, yes, I am coming soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. May the grace of God, may the grace of the Lord Jesus be with God's holy people. Those are the last words of the Bible. What an amazing, amazing message. I had a lot of people talk to me this weekend and tell me that I was a little crazy to be preaching from the book of Revelation, but I think it's an amazing message. It's a book that scares a lot of people, but it needn't be that way. They all have something to say. You know, and eventually, that wondering question I had left, because I went on to other Sunday school classes, and it assured me that the Holy Spirit was still here, still working in this world. There is one thing, though, that has endured. One thing that still troubles me. You know, some people get the idea that the Holy Spirit is contained in this book and that it's nowhere else in this world. Or that it's contained within the walls of this church, but not outside the walls of this church. Or it's contained in the sacrament of baptism or the sacrament of communion, but it's not found outside of those sacraments. There are many people that believe that. And it's a concern. You know, when they ask what's wrong with the church, I tell everyone, we're not preaching God anymore. We're entertaining ourselves. We're counting to see how many get in the pews on Sunday morning, not who is sitting in the pews on Sunday morning. So today we heard from that last page of the Bible. We heard from that last word of the Bible. There's more in the book of Revelation. And I want to bring up one other verse that we didn't touch on this morning. I want to bring up the fifth verse of Revelation. Because it kind of brings to a crescendo all those images that the book of Revelation puts before you. It's just a symphony of images regarding the citizens of New Jerusalem. And that scripture reads, and there will be no more night. They need no light or lamp or sun, for the Lord God will be their light. And they will reign forever and ever. You know, and I get to think of this, what more can be said after that verse? What more can be said after that glorious conclusion of verse 1 passage? And that last sentence in the passage repeats an invitation, not a conclusion. It invites us. The Spirit says, come. The bride says, come. Everyone who hears is to say, come. And where are they to come? What does this tell us? It says, to come to the fountain of living water. It tells us that water is offered for everyone who wants to come drink. The fountain of living water is not just mentioned in Revelation, you know. It's also mentioned in John's Gospel. Remember the story about Jesus and the woman from the well in the Samaritan town of Sychar? They run into each other at the well, and they start a conversation. And in the course of the conversation, Jesus tells her that whoever drinks of the water from this well will be thirsty again. But if you drink from the water that I give you, the water will spring of water, gushing even into eternal life. This is the same water that the last page of the Bible invites us to drink. This is the enduring gift of Jesus Christ that those final verses announce in the conclusion, which is no conclusion at all, but a fresh start. A fresh start. Baptism is one of those fresh starts, isn't it? Holy Communion is one of those fresh starts. We have many fresh starts in the Bible all through Jesus Christ. He says, let anyone who is thirsty come to me. He called it out. And let the one who believes in me drink. That's what the scripture tells us. Out of the believer's heart shall flow rivers of living water. It's more than a matter of just having water to drink. The one who receives this water, this gift of living water, also becomes another source of it. In this life, on this world, because of our faith, because of our belief, because we have received that gift, and we believe in that gift, we are now givers of that gift. That's something I just quite hadn't grasped before. We now, until Jesus comes in, are givers of that gift of living water, and we should be offering it to those who never need to be thirsty again. The last page, let's talk about it again. I want to remind you once more as we close this message out. It's not an inclusion. It is an invitation. We are invited to keep